How well do you understand the pricing options in NetSuite? We're going to break down the pricing options into two categories: pricing options on item records and pricing options on customer records. First, let's look at the pricing options that are available for selection on item records. All of these options can be found under the sales/pricing tab of an item record. We're going to look at five different features: price levels, quantity pricing schedules, pricing groups, and multi-currency pricing. To begin with, we need to understand price levels. Price levels allow you to have different prices for the same item. NetSuite calls this feature multiple pricing. With multiple pricing, users can create up to 1,000 different price levels. When you create a new price level, you specify the markup or discount percentage for that level. A positive percentage will result in a price markup from the base price of an item, while a negative percentage will result in a price discount. On an item record, any active price levels that have been created for your account will appear in the price level column. As you can see for this item, the base price is $100. Notice that three of the price levels have been configured to automatically apply a discount to the base price, but two of the price levels, test manual level and the web store price, need to be entered manually. If no price is entered in the web store price field, NetSuite automatically uses the base price of the item in a company's online store. To use a price level like test manual level, however, you would need to enter the specific price you want. Next, let's look at how quantity pricing affects this item record. Quantity pricing allows companies to provide discounts to customers who purchase certain items in bulk. Once you have enabled the quantity pricing feature in NetSuite and decided on the maximum number of quantity levels you want to appear on any item record, you are ready to set specific base prices for each desired quantity on item records. Notice that for this item, we have decided to provide discounts for customers who buy quantities of 10 or more, 50 or more, and 100 or more. Once we enter the base price for these quantities, NetSuite automatically shows us what the price level discounts would be as a result of those base prices. Now, when any customer purchases 10 or more of this item up to 49, NetSuite will automatically use the base price of $90 on the sales order. And if the sales rep selects, say, the price level for 5% off the base price on the sales order, then NetSuite will apply both the price level discount and the base price discount, resulting in a final price of $85.50 for each item in the order. While we're talking about quantity pricing, we also need to understand the options available in the field Calculate Quantity Discounts. Quantity can be a tricky thing to measure. Do you want to apply discounts based on the quantity of an item on a single line of a sales order? What if the same item shows up on multiple lines of the sales order? NetSuite provides four different ways for you to calculate quantity. To learn more about each of these ways, simply select the field name and read through the field help details. As you can imagine, setting up quantity pricing for each item record your company has could be extremely time-consuming. Quantity pricing schedules allow you to build quantity pricing templates that you can quickly apply to any items. When you create a new quantity pricing schedule, you decide what discounts you want to provide for different quantities. You also decide whether you want to measure quantity numerically or by a specific unit. For example, if you sell cloth, then you may want to provide discounts for the number of yards of fabric that a customer buys. Once you have the pricing schedules you need, you would simply select the appropriate schedule directly on the item record. Then, once you enter the base price for that item, NetSuite will apply your predefined quantity pricing template. Next, let's look at pricing groups. Pricing groups are simply a helpful way to organize related items. For example, if you sell different types of mugs, then you might create a pricing group called mugs. If the item you are working with belongs in a pricing group, then you would select that group from the pricing group drop-down list. Once you have associated an item with a specific pricing group, you can select that group on customer records so that NetSuite knows to apply this pricing group's price levels for those customers. We'll return to this concept in the section on customer records. The final item record pricing feature is multi-currency pricing. Multi-currency pricing allows companies that need to conduct business in more than one currency to manage their prices for each of those currencies. NetSuite automatically provides for USD, CAD, EUR, and GBP, but you would need to create currency records for any currencies you will be using beyond these four. If your NetSuite instance does use multiple currencies, then you would need to set the base currency for your company, which is the currency that NetSuite will default to. Each subsidiary in a company can have its own base currency. You may have noticed the different currency tabs here on our item record. Each of these currencies have the same price level options and quantity pricing options as the USD tab, All you would need to do is put in the base price for the item in that currency, and NetSuite will do the rest. Now we're ready to look at the pricing options available on customer records. These pricing options enable you to provide customer-specific pricing discounts. First, navigate to the desired customer record and click Edit. Then select the Financial subtab. The three pricing options in particular that are available to you are Price Level, Group Pricing, and Item Pricing. In the Price Level field, you can choose to have a specific price level always apply to this customer's orders. For example, maybe you have a deal with this customer that causes them to always get 15% off the base price of your items. Setting that price level directly on their customer record ensures that the customer isn't mistakenly charged above the agreed upon discount. In the Group Pricing tab at the bottom of the record, you can allow your customer to get a specific price level discount on any items they purchase within a particular pricing group. Simply select the pricing group and the desired price level you want to give the customer for that group. You can repeat this process for as many pricing groups as you wish. You can also choose to give customers discounts for specific items under the Item Pricing tab. Simply select the desired item and choose which price level you want to apply for this customer when they purchase this item. As with group pricing, you can repeat this process for as many items as you wish. The pricing options in NetSuite ensure that your pricing, with all of its nuances, is always accurate for all your items and all your customers. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.